Hi, I'm Justin Grover. I'm a product manager with the Adobe Analytics product team, and today I want to show you some of the features of the Adobe Experience Cloud Debugger related to analytics. This is a Chrome extension that is available in the Chrome Web Store for you to download and add into Chrome. What this Chrome extension does is it places a button up in your toolbar that you can use to launch the debugger. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how this is used to inspect the tags of a web page. This page is tagged with several Adobe products, and so I'm going to actually open up the debugger to view the different tags for those products. Here we can see that I have some information about the page, and then I can see which products are implemented on the page itself. I'm going to go to the Adobe Analytics tab, and in that tab, it will actually show me each of the report suites that I have tagged on this page. If I look at these report suites, they will actually show me the variables that are being set on the page, the values they're being set to, and the friendly names of those variables. I can then download these into Excel. Having this data in Excel lets me do two things that I find really useful. First, it lets me share it with others who may not be familiar with Adobe Analytics and how it's implemented. Second, I can save this information for future use, and it lets me keep track of how the data might be changing over time, especially if I have use cases that I run on a regular basis, like test cases. One of the things that is really valuable with this tool is it actually gives me the friendly names of the variables, like we mentioned earlier. To get the friendly names like you see here, you actually go down to the bottom of the page, click on the Link Account button, and you log in with your Adobe credentials, and that will download the metadata from the analytics account. So now that we have our accounts linked and we have the friendly names here, as I navigate through the site, I can see how this data is populating, and it keeps a history of everything that I've done while this window is open. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these two side by side, and then I'm going to go ahead and click on another page in this site. And there we see that that another server call came in from the second page, and I can actually start to compare them, how they're changing over time. This has been a quick overview of the Adobe Experience Cloud Debugger as it relates to the analytics implementation. We hope that it helps you as you're trying to validate your implementation.